Friday, proper sunny day here. We're going for a walk. It's really bad lighting. I've got coconut oil all over my face and hair because it's good for me.
Rob, look at this view.
Yeah, look at this. From our hike, we did over 12,000 steps. It was sick. Breaking the fast a bit early. It's about 2 p.m. and I haven't even hit the gym yet, but I fancy some things. I'm gonna hit one banana, one chopped apple, bit of cinnamon sprinkled on top. Mid-afternoon, heading to the gym to do a push workout. My neck and shoulders still pretty junky, glued up, so I'm gonna do some work on that for about 5-10 minutes and then get into some bench press. Hopefully I don't mess it up anymore. So after rolling and stretching out my shoulder for about 10-15 minutes, it did feel better, but I decided not to do barbell bench press and went for the dumbbells up, which I feel I can keep my elbows tighter and keep the shoulder in a less compromised position, in a better position. Here I went pretty heavy, 95 each side, which was probably a bit too heavy as I needed Jay to spot me on nearly every rep. So maybe, yeah, it wasn't too clever. I should have gone a little bit lighter, but was doing reverse pyramid, my classic. So first set very heavy, 4-5 reps, and then obviously dropping it down for the subsequent sets after. So this was 95-4-4, I think, but that was a bit too heavy. I should have gone a bit lighter. Had two and a half, three minute breather, and then went into 85. So dropped the weight by 10 pounds on each dumbbell, and then up the reps. So here it's 6 reps on 85, and this didn't feel too bad, to be honest. So I just was feeling this more than barbell, and it's good to mix up your pressing exercises from barbell to dumbbells. Bit of a different stimulus, and like I said, I feel I can keep the elbow a lot tighter compared to the barbell. So if my shoulder or elbow is feeling a little bit junky, a little bit glued up, it can be a good alternative. Again, this is my third set and I dropped it down to 75 now, and this felt easy. I busted out 8 reps easy, and I did a fourth and fifth set of this, which I didn't film. But again, this is my money movement. This is where I get my gains, my strength and my hypertrophy. So I'm always going to do that reverse pyramid. Start heavy, take 10% off, and 10% off again, but increasing the reps, getting more volume in there. After that, I thought that's enough heaviness, enough load through the system. So instead of doing weighted dips today, I just did body weight dips, but again going more for volume. So I did 5 sets of 20 reps, and this is my first set, and I'm only going to show you one set because it'd be boring if you saw me do 100 dips. But I was focusing more on contraction, keeping myself in a good position, and yeah, I didn't feel like adding weight in. Even though my shoulder felt better than it had been feeling, I didn't really want to strap, you know, 40 kilos to myself. So yeah, this workout ended up turning into a bit of a bodybuilding pump, which is good. If you're feeling like you're a bit fatigued, why not? I use this as a stretch as well as a contraction exercise, a little bit of chest flies, 4 sets on this, and not too heavy, just going light, getting a stretch through the pecs and then contracting. And sometimes I'll cross over my wrists just to really squeeze the contraction of the chest. Other times I'll just bring my knuckles together. But chest flies are cool. Again, a little supplement. My main exercise for pushing is always going to be my bench or incline bench or even overhead press. But these do supplement those main movements. And here I'm just finishing off. So I did 3-4 sets on that, I think. And after that, same machine, I went for some tricep push down. Again, not heavy. I was doing more of a pump here. So I think I even went too light on this. I was looking to hit 12 reps on my first set. I might have even hit 15 reps. But I wanted to go for 3 sets of this. Again, just to finish off my triceps, which have already been worked quite hard in all the other pushing exercises. But yeah, I would normally go for around 12 to 15 on these supplement exercises. Anything more than 15, you're going too heavy. And the last one I did was my favorite at the moment, these Skull Crusher kickbacks with, and again, these are light, it's like 20 pounds, but my triceps kind of felt like toast. I was feeling swole as a mofo. But yeah, as you can see on this one, I'm not extending my arm all the way up. I'm keeping that angle just a little bit, so there's tension on the triceps the whole time. I think I busted out about 10 or 12, before I thought, that's enough of that. And that was my workout for the day. Pretty chilled.
5 p.m. that little pump push session's done. Felt good actually, my shoulder feels a lot better, did some mobility on it and didn't hit the bench or weight and stuff as you saw, so feeling good. I've got a craving for those protein cookies, they're so good, so I'm gonna go to Whole Foods, get one of those and head back and do some more work. So they had a deal in Whole Foods, two of these, $4, $2 each. Man, they're so good. I'm gonna eat one now, save one for tomorrow. They're like 16 grams protein. The macros are okay, like they're actually quite high calorie, they're like 350, 380 calories a pop, but they're so damn good. They're vegan, no eggs, no dairy, no soy. They're sick. If you see one, try one.
So good. It's kind of like cakey. It's so good. I was just looking online, apparently Conor McGregor has signed the contract to fight Floyd Mayweather in September. Still waiting for Floyd to sign apparently. I want to see that fight, that's going to be sick. I don't know who would win, probably Floyd. My money's on Floyd, but it'll still be a sick fight.
Just finished some work. Jay, what's guanin over there for dins?
What's guanin? We've got organic potatoes in there. We're gonna have vegan mashed potatoes. We've got vegan sausages.
Yes, please. What's 20, the macros on those?
29 grams of protein per sausage.
Thanks, I will.
12 grams of fat. Okay, 12 grams of carbs. I mean, the macros are pretty good. 29 grams of protein per sausage, so, and they're nice. We've got collard greens here, which I'm gonna boil and then saute with garlic. And if you look here in the rice cooker steamer, we have asparagus and damn, loads of broccoli. And
green festival.
Not only that, this spinach is being wilted down in a sec as well.